Welcome to this presentation of Snap Creator Framework. Today we're going to discuss using SnapDrive with Snap Creator. By default, Snap Creator makes API calls for storage actions. Alternatively, a snapshot create command can be supplied that can be used to call other products, such as SnapDrive, to take snapshots. The SnapDrive command must be added to allowedcommands.config in order to work. When setting up a snapshot create command, you can use variables to name your snapshots. To name your snapshots in typical NetApp style, use the variables as shown on screen. SName is the snapshot name defined in the configuration file. SnapType is the retention policy for the snapshot. It's often something like hourly or daily, but if you're using SnapCreator policy objects, then the policy name will be listed. And SnapTime is the date and timestamp of the snapshots. The example command on screen is the one that I'll be using in this video. Let's see how this works. I'm logged into the SnapCreator GUI and I have selected the configuration file that I created as part of the Creating a Domino configuration video. With the configuration file open, I can click on the Commands tab. At the very bottom is the Snapshot Copy Create command. To add a command, simply click Add and type in your command. Save, and then click Reload. Next time I perform the backup action, SnapCreator will call the snapshot create command that I just specified, which in this case calls SnapDrive. However, since the SnapDrive command exists outside of SnapCreator, I first have to tell SnapCreator that it's okay to run it. To do this, I go into the directory where the SnapCreator agent is installed. Within the etc subdirectory, there's a file called allowed_commands.config. In Windows, simply double-click the file to edit it in either WordPad or Notepad, depending on your settings. The syntax is very easy. There's a single line called command. It's blank by default, but if you wish to add additional commands that SnapCreator can run, simply add the commands. It does need to be fully qualified. So in this case, I'm adding C, program files, NetApp, SnapDrive, sdcli.exe. I do not need to include any of the parameters that follow sdcli.exe. If you need to add additional commands, simply add additional lines. When you're done with the changes, save the file. In order for the changes to take effect, you do need to restart the SnapCreator agent. Do this in any method that you like, but the easiest to me is to open a command prompt and type sc, which is Windows Service Control, not related to SnapCreator, sc, query SnapCreator agent service. The query command shows me that the SnapCreator agent is currently running. I can stop SnapCreator using the command sc stop SnapCreator agent service. If I query it again, I can see that it has in fact stopped. I then run the command sc start SnapCreator agent service. You could just as easily do this through the services snap-in in Windows. Now we go back to our SnapCreator GUI and take a backup. Scroll through the log file until you find the section titled Snapshot Create Commands. As you can see from the output on screen, SnapCreator is now calling the command that we supplied within the configuration file. And we can see that the snapshot create completed successfully. These steps showed how to update an existing configuration to use SnapDrive. That completes this presentation of SnapCreator 4.1, using SnapDrive with SnapCreator. For additional information about SnapCreator, visit the SnapCreator Developers Community at www.snapcreator.com or visit the SnapCreator Forum on NetApp Communities at www.netapp.com/snapcreator.